It's time for GC Kids! Children's Church Bible Study. I am so happy that all of you have joined us today. And I am so happy for all of you that joined us in Children's Church this morning. Today, we talked more about having a fresh start. We talked about all the things that can make us go rotten, like sin, all the stuff that could tempt us. That is the reason we have to stay fresh in the Spirit, keep ourselves clean from all that temptation, walk in love, walk in righteousness, walk as an example to others, fighting off the temptation of sin or the deception of sin. We're going to talk a little bit more about that today in our afternoon Bible study. Let's open in prayer and then we'll move forward. Everybody, close your eyes, bow your heads. Dear God, thank you so much for this time, for this opportunity we have to walk in your word, to learn more about what you have for us, so that we can be examples to the world around us. Help keep us clean, wash us of our sin, help us fight off temptation and deception to do things that we aren't supposed to do. Help us to be a light and an example to the world around us. In Jesus' name, everybody says, amen. So, we've been talking about being an example, being a light to the world around us. Today, in Children's Church, we talked about fighting off temptation, living a life clean from sin. When we talk about being clean, it's talking about asking God's forgiveness, but also making the right choices, being righteous, making the right choices to stand off sin, to fight it off. That's why today's word is righteous. So, next Sunday when I say, does anybody know the secret word for today? You raise your hand. I'll choose somebody random and say, hey, I choose you. And then you say the word. If you didn't have your hand up to begin with, you don't get to share the word and get a special prize. We have Airheads, we have chocolate, we have squishies, we have fidget spinners that we'll be giving out. You won't know what you're going to get until after you share the word. So please pay close attention and remember that the word is righteous. That means to make the right choices. So when we talk to Children's Church today about being fresh, about making the right choices, we've learned about following God's direction and fighting off sin. That's what we're going to focus on in our Bible study today. After this video is over, I want you to sit down with your parents and read through 1 John chapter 3, all the way from number 1 to the very end, and then discuss what it tells us about righteousness, what it tells us about love, and what it tells us about being an example for the world around us. With that being said, let's jump a bit more into what it means to be fresh, to be cleaned from sin with our puppet song. And then we're going to dive deep into a special investigation I have put out by a special detective agency called the DOG to learn what righteousness is, and learn what we can do to live a righteous life. With that being said, let's take it over to our amazing puppet friends and the special song that they have prepared for us. And then we're gonna dive deep into the files of the DOG. Are you ready? Here we go.
Darkness and sin. There's one special detective agency that specializes in the act of righteousness. That means to make the right choices. They are the Department Observing Godliness, or the DOG for short. This is one of their files. Today's file, 115. The Stink of Temptation.
It was just another day in the office, until he walked in.
Excuse me, sir, are you a detective?
Why, yes I am. Detective Sherlock Bones at your service.
Detective, I need your help with something.
How can I help you, my aunt friend?
I've got a big problem.
I can see that you are a very large aunt.
No, not my size. I got a problem. Me and my brother, we were playing around, and we broke my mom's favorite vase. It broke into a million pieces. And my brother, he says that we should lie to my mother and tell her it was an earthquake. I don't know what to do. Detective Sherlock Bones, can you help me?
Why, I think I can. Let's start by looking at what the Word of God tells us about this situation. In 1 John 3, 7, it says, "Little children, let no one deceive you.
He who practices righteousness is righteous, just as he was righteous. He is talking about Jesus. It says we cannot let others deceive us to do the wrong thing. We have to make the right choice. That's what righteousness is, the right choice. Or the choice that Jesus would make, because Jesus was our example for righteousness. So let's look at our options. First option is you lie to your mother. Second option, you tell her the truth and accept any consequences. Let's see, which one would be the right choice? The Bible teaches us that we should not lie. It's actually one of the Ten Commandments that God gave to Moses. So we know that lying is wrong. So I think you know what choice you have to make.
Yes, I should tell the truth to my mother and accept any consequences because it was my mistake. I was the one who did something wrong.
Very true. Well, thank you very much for coming in. Have a great day. Righteousness, making the right choices. Many times people will try to tempt us to do the wrong thing, but it's up to us to make the right choice. If you are reading or watching this file, you might find more information on this if you sit down with your parents and read 1 John chapter 3 all the way through. It tells us about righteousness and living with love. Another case has been solved by the DOG, Department Observing Godliness. This is Detective Sherlock Bones, signing off.